for the final section. Want to come in here, we're going to cast a little bit of light. And I would explain all this to you, but I really do this in an abstract fashion. And I never really know what's going to happen, so I can't really explain it more or less like that. So we need to add some light down here. Just pick up just a little bit of this yellow and kind of beat it down in that brush pretty good and the bristles there, because all you want to do is just kind of tap in some color just barely on the edge like that, kind of brighten it up. And since that's blue, it's going to change color. It's going to end up, you're going to get some green in there. And you want to kind of follow where this light's going and kind of brighten it up down in there. And it'll make it look like it's casting light out that way. And kind of like that. And we're going to come back in with some highlights right up in through here. And oh yeah, in the corners there where we did our stuff. And anyway, we want to cast some other light going in other directions. I wanted to, since I've highlighted the top of these clouds, I wanted something that was coming this way. So you have to make sure that your geometry is correct. And that's what I've been using the stick for, is you line it up to center of where your bright spot is. And you get just a little bit of paint in your brush and kind of halfway beat it in. You don't have to beat it in all the way. And come into the edge of your bright spot here on the back of your cloud. And you just kind of ease that in there like that and just give you a general guideline. And then you can kind of spread it apart just like this. And you want to leave a little gap in there, and it makes it look like the light's shining in various ways, just like I did over here and here and right here and up in there. And you just kind of brush the color in like that, and it's going to change color now as it runs across all these other colors. It's going to change color a little bit as the painting sets up, but don't worry about that, because you can see through colors of light into the background colors, so it'll naturally change a little bit in the perception that you think you see it in. So it's fine, it'll be fine. You don't have to worry about color changes or anything, because it's part of the art. Just come in, like I said, make a general little line, and then you can come out and kind of spread it out. Like this. You can kind of brighten in this whole area. Because you'll get less and less paint in your brush as you work it. So you'll have your brightest line on one side and it'll fade out on the other side. And it gives you a really dramatic effect just like that. I want to do one more light ray coming this way. I wanted to do something coming back over this way to kind of go over that line of light there to add just a little bit more depth to the painting. And we come in like right here. Come in like right here. I don't want to hit this. I want to just like that, your little general guideline. And then remember, you want to get wider and wider as you go. Because that's how that light works. It gets wider as you go. Because you want to follow that geometry. just like that. You see, it's kind of look like it's bending in right there. So you kind of sharpen that edge up just a little bit. Right across that one right there, just like that. And when you add that, it looks like it's going over or under. And we'll change the look of everything just like that. And we'll lay our filbert off to the side. And we're gonna get some white paint. Just plain white. We're not gonna mix it this time. Just plain white. And this is what we're gonna use for our highlights, and then we'll be done with our piece. Just come in and highlight these, and remember, if you have a, when you start, you're going to have a thick bead of paint right there, so you drag it out in the opposite direction, and it kind of fades out as it goes, because you get less and less, like I said, you get less and less paint in your brush, so you would want to start at where the brightest point would be, where this light's shining in. You kind of work away from that. Hitting the top of these bright points where the darkest is above and the brightest is below, like that, and it makes it look like it's casting shadow, casting light. When you do that, you just got to remember where to put your highlight. It's really about all there is to it. Come in here and kind of touch this like this, and it doesn't have to be thick paint, you just want to highlight it. You just want to do just a little highlight and kind of confuse the eye when you're looking at this. And if you have any mistakes in there, or what you think is a mistake, it'll cover it, it'll make it look like it's supposed to. Like if you were actually looking at a photograph of a nebula, it'll add that effect that you're, it gives you that depth that you're looking for. Because you're always looking for your bright points and your dark points. And that's what's going to give you your depth and the type of painting like this, and casting this light over the top of stuff. So when you throw these light beams is dependent on what is forward and what is back. So it's not necessarily it's how you stack it. Just like in a landscape painting, there's really not any difference. It's the same. And you can create a piece like this. All you have to do is follow these few little steps that I showed you in this painting. And like I said, it happens in a really abstract way. So you know, you don't have to worry about making a mistake. You can cover it up with some highlights and stuff and just kind of keep going, and nobody will ever know that you made what it is that you think is a mistake. They'll think you did it on purpose, and they'll say, "Wow, man, you're an incredible artist." And you know, you just, all you did was best you could. You know, you come in with something like this, and hey, I'm telling you that you can do this if you want to. It's really not that difficult. You see how easy it is to use that filbert brush? That's this one. That filbert brush, this one, and it makes the clouds. And then you come back in with this script liner and you highlight, and it brings out, it makes it look like you have a lot of detail in there, even though you really might not have that much. But it really brings it out, makes a nice piece, and we're almost done. And far to go here, people. We're bound in this corner. We need to go over to the other corner and sign it. Put our initials on it. We'll do that down here. So that I don't interfere with the artwork. And it looks like part of the art. And there you go. We're going to call this Nebula 120G. Y'all have a good day now.